So this is example problem C at the bottom of page 2 of your chapter 28 lecture notes. So in this example problem, we have a wire in the positive y direction with a current of 1.5 amps flowing in the positive y direction. A second wire is orientated also in the y direction, but now the current is flowing in the negative y direction with 2 amps. And we know that the wires are 5 centimeters apart. We want to know what the magnitude and direction of the magnetic field at a point directly between the two wires. So because it's a field, we have to remember there doesn't actually have to be an object sitting there to experience the field for the field to exist. Since we have two wires, that means we need to sum the magnetic field from wire 1 with the magnetic field from wire 2. Which is why I've written our equation twice. And I'm using this particular equation because we're dealing with wires. So this applies to the straight current carrying conductor. So this is the equation we derived in the prior video. I'm also now applying my right-hand rule, which is why I've got two negative signs here. So since this goes in the positive y direction, I'm going to point my thumb in the direction of the positive y direction. And remember, you have to stick your hand, pretend like you're sticking your hand behind the wire. So you're grabbing the wire and holding it with your thumb pointed in the positive y direction. That tells you when you're on the right side of the wire, your fingers are going to point downward through the page, which is going to point us in the negative z direction. You then, for the second wire, need to flip your hand over. Once again, grab the wire. And as you're grabbing your wire, you'll note that your hands have to go down into the page at the point of interest on the now left side of the wire, which is why it's also in the negative z direction. So that's why there's a negative sign here. Because we're dealing with a point directly in between the two wires, that means the r for both of them, so the radial distance away from the wire is the same for both, which is why I factored it out down here. So the only difference between the two magnetic field equations is going to be the fact that the currents are different. So I factored out the constant. This is also a constant. They're both negative, and R is the same in this particular case. It may not always be true, though, so be careful of that. So now I plugged my numbers in with my two different currents, and I've done some reducing. When I did this problem originally, my calculator batteries had died, so I was trying to do a lot of combining before I type things into my calculator on my phone, and then you can see the answer here. Remember that the units for magnetic field strength are Teslas, and technically speaking, this should then be in the negative z direction or into the page.